As we start this short devotional, I want to remind you again of what the Word of God says. It says, all Scripture is profitable. And He lists a number of things we can learn from Scripture. And often when God has been working in the Old Testament, these are examples for us. We see where people were being blessed and where people failed, and we're to learn from that. And today we are looking at one wonderful example of God's blessing on a man's life. And this is found in Deuteronomy 1:36. And he said this, that the whole children of Israel, out of all the children of Israel, God said Caleb and his descendants would inherit the land. Why? Why of all the thousands and thousands of people that God said Caleb would go into the land where all the rest of them would not? And God tells us why. Because he wholeheartedly followed the Lord. And God wants us to follow him wholeheartedly, not half-heartedly, not for any other reasons except we want to be obedient. And also he said that Caleb's decision to follow God wholeheartedly not only affected himself, but his children and children's children. It's a tremendous example given to us in Scripture. He's saying that his decision to follow God wholeheartedly with all his heart would benefit his children and future generations. So I need to realize that the choices that I make personally can have long-range benefit on my family. And this is repeated again in Psalms, and I like to read this. This is out of the King James Bible. And in Psalms 103, verse 17, God said, but the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon those who fear him, and that person's righteousness, because he's chosen to do what's right, will reach down to children and children's children. What a tremendous promise. My obedience or disobedience can have a long-range effect on my family line. We don't live for ourselves, and we don't make choices only because they're right, but there can be long-range benefits for my children and my children's children. We have four children. A number of them are still single. We have, I think it's seven or eight grandchildren, sorry. And we have lots of great-grandchildren. And years ago, I never thought that the decisions I would make would have any effect on my great-grandchildren. But God says that they do. In the USA, our culture is more me-centered. It's all about me, what I want. All the advertisements that are pushed our way, all the broadcasts that we received, it's all about me. And God says, it's not all about me. It's all about generations. Many of the countries that are watching us think in terms of generations. And that is the proper way to think. That's the way God wants me to think. Not only about my immediate family, but my children, my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren, all the descendants that will come for me. And I realize that is a very sobering thought. that what I do or don't do can have long-range effect on future generations. I trust that that will be a blessing to you, and ask God, am I following you wholeheartedly? Bless you.